فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى، what we will be starting today is the explanation of this great book, Mukhtasar fi Usul al-Aqaid al-Diniyah, written by none other than the great noble scholar Abdul Rahman ibn Nasir ibn Abdullah ibn Sa'di, who died the year 1376. He is the author of this book. We have previously taken his biography. We took his biography where? In the explanation of Risalatul Latifa, right? Or Qawa'id al-Fiqhiyya, na'am. So inshallah ta'ala, we're not going to waste more time in, what do you call it, in the biography of the author and who he is. فَوَ غَنِيٌّ عَنِ التَّعْرِيفِ. He's, mashallah, well known, and there's no need for us to dwell over his biography. We're now going to start the sharah and the explanation of this particular book. And inshallah ta'ala, as we go on, we'll find more about what this book is about. نعم تفضل.
الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وأتباعه إلى يوم الدين.
So as you can see, the author, he started his book by saying الحمد لله رب العالمين. Praises to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the Lord of the universe. العالمين, universe. So الحمد, praises to him سبحانه وتعالى. وصلى الله, and may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala send down salutation on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa alihi and his family. Al is short for what? Ahl. Wa sahbihi and his companions. And companion is who? Man laqiya an-nabiy sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mu'minan bihi wa mata 'ala al-islam wa law takhallalat riddatuhu 'ala al-asah. A companion is the person who met the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he died upon iman, even if there came a time he apostated, it doesn't matter. Na'am. Wa atba'ihi is the followers, those who have followed him, alayhi salatu wasalam. And the companions, they follow the companions. إلى يوم الدين, until the day of judgment. إلى أن يرث الله الأرض ومن عليها, until Allah takes over everything that's on this earth and everyone on it. So we say praise to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, the Lord of the universe. Now this is the difference between hamd and shukr. Because when you say Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, you're praising Allah for what? For that which He is, not for what He has done for you necessarily. Shukr is not. Shukr is only what you have done for me. So بينهما عموم وخصوص. There is that difference between the two of them. So who is more comprehensive? Who is more general now? Hamd or shukr? Hamd is right, because hamd is for what you've done for me and also what you are. Isn't that the case? So in that, from that angle, hamd is more broader than a shukr. But there are times when shukr, or there is a time when shukr is more broader than hamd. When is that? When we look at where it occurs from, where it happens from. Hamd only happens from the mouth and the heart. That's it. Whereas shukr happens from the what? The mouth and the heart and the limbs. Because Allah says in the Quran, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا دَاوُدَ مِنَّا فَضْلًا يَا جِبَالَ أَوِّبِي مَعَهُ وَالطَّيْرَ وَأَلَنَّا لَهُ الْحَدِيدَ أَنْ اعْمَلْ صَابِغَاتٍ وَقَدِّرْ فِي السَّرْدِ وَاعْمَلُوا صَالِحًا إِنِّي بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ وَلِسُلَيْمَانَ الرِّيحَ غُدُوُّهَا شَهْرٌ وَرَوَاحُهَا شَهْرٌ وَأَرْسَلْنَا لَهُ عَيْنَ الْقِطِّ وَمِنَ الْجِنِّ مَنْ يَعْمَلُ بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ بِإِذْنِهِ وَمَنْ يَزِغْ مِنْهُمْ عَنْ أَمْرِنَا نُذِقْهُ مِنْ عَذَابِ السَّعِيرِ يَعْلَمُونَ لَهُ مَا يَشَاءُ مِنْ مَحَارِيبَ وَتَمَاثِيلَ وَجِفَانِ كَالْجِبَالِ وَقُدُورِ الرَّاسِ اعْمَلُوا آلَ دَاوُدَ شُكْرًا هَذَا اعْمَلُوا آلَ دَاوُدَ شُكْرًا. All the people of Dawood, show gratitude on your limbs. You see? So the shukr occurs from the limbs. So بينهما, the scholars, they say بينهما عموم وخصوص. عموم وخصوص meaning generalization, specification. أما بعد is to proceed. صحيح؟ أما بعد is to proceed. أما بعد is a what? نائبة. نائب means it's take, أما is taking the place of something else. It's taking the place of what? مهما يكون من أمر. Whatever the case may be. That's what it means. And the scholars, they differ upon who's the first person to say it. The majority of the overwhelming scholars, they say that the first person to say was to what? Nabiullah Dawood alayhi salam. When Allah says, we gave him fasl al-khitab, they say this is amma ba'du. Anyway, sometimes scholars, they say wa ba'du, and it's not good to say wa ba'du. It's better to say amma ba'du. Ittiba'an lil-Nabi sallallahu alayhi salam, following the Prophet alayhi salatu salam. So to proceed. So when we hear amma ba'du, we know intiqal min uslubin ila akhar. Sahih? So don't, balagha uslub would be uslub ilmi or uslub adabi, that's different types of. No, it doesn't mean that. It means from the muqaddima, from the introduction. We're moving away from the introduction now and we're going to go to the subul mawdu', the actual topic that we want to talk about now. To proceed means I've thanked Allah, praised Him for what He deserves, subhanahu wa ta'ala, or with the great characteristics that He has. I've also sent salutation on the Prophet ﷺ and the companions and the believers until the day of judgment. Now I want to go to my topic at hand. So you're moving from that speech to the topic that you want to speak about. Now.
فهذا مختصر جدا في أصول العقائد الدينية.
So this فهذا, remember when أما بعد comes, majority of the time scholars they mention. But remember the fa is جواب, it's an answer to the أما بعد, remember. So فهذا, what is this هذا pointing at? هذا is an إشارة, right, in the Arabic language, like you're pointing at something. هذا and هذه. So the Sheikh is pointing at something. What is he pointing at right now? But then, this is the question that arises now. It can be something which is mahsus, tangible. Or it can be something which is in his head. If he had authored the book, and the book was, because the majority, a lot of the scholars, not the majority, but a lot of the scholars, what they do is they write the book. They author the book. Once they've written the book, then they write the introduction. They go and they write the introduction. Because they know what they've written, they have an idea of what they've written, the introduction is easier for them to write. That's one way of doing it. So when he has already, if that's what he has done, he has written the book, and then he goes for the introduction, then the hadihi ama the hada is referring to what he's already written. But if he hasn't written the book, and he's now put the pen on the paper, and he started with the introduction, where can that hada go to? It's what's in his head that he's going to write, he's planning to write, is what he's referring to. Wahada, this in my head right now. You see? So فَهَذَا this مُخْتَصَرٌ, the word مُخْتَصَر in the Arabic language is مَا قَلَّ لَفْظُهُ, it's anything that the wordings are very little, but not necessarily the meaning. I might have some, it's basically summarization or to abridge something. But it, just because I've abridged something, just because I've summarized something, it doesn't necessarily mean I've got rid of the powerful meaning that I could have portrayed. It's still probably there. Or it's, I'm trying to bring that meaning still there, but I've summarized it. I've made it into something very short. So the مختصر in the Arabic language is what? مَا قَلَّ لَفْظُهُ وَجَلَّ مَعْنَهُ. Its wordings are little, but the meaning is powerful, it's vast. The meaning is, and the truth of the matter is this book that in front of us, inshallah ta'ala, that we're going to study. Without a shadow of a doubt, it's a book that وَلَهُ مِنْ إِسْمِهِ نَصِيبٌ وَلَهُ مِنْ إِسْمِهِ نَصِيبٌ. That is, وَلَهُ مِنْ إِسْمِهِ نَصِيبٌ means that it is what its name is. It is summarized and abridged, but reality of the matter is that it is powerful. The meaning has not gone. The author, rahimahullah, he gave it justice. Na'am. So sorry, مختصر جدا. I've summarized it very much. في أصول العقائد الدينية. But it's what topic? It's in أصول العقائد الدينية. Fundamental credo matters. It's in what? Fundamental credo matters. And inshallah, as we're going to see, the Shaykh رحمه الله تعالى رحمة واسعة, he broke it into five أصول. Five usul he broke into. And we shall see, inshallah ta'ala, each asl and what it's talking about, what the topic is about. Na'am.
Wal usul al kabirati al muhimma. Iqtasanna fiha ala mujarrad al isharati wa tanbih. Min ghayri basdin lil kalami wa la dhikri adillatiha.
So the Sheikh, look what he's saying right now. He's now telling you the way he's going to write the book. And the way he's authoring the book. What did he say? I've sufficed myself, I basically stuck to, though in writing the book, this book, عَلَى مُجَرَّدِ الْإِشَارَةِ وَالتَّنْبِيهِ. I'm only going to point out. I'm only going to what? I'm only going to point out. I'm not going to go into tafasil, detailed matters and explanation, no. My job here right now is just to point out, just to bring to your attention something. And he said, مِنْ غَيْرِ بَصْدِ لِلْكَلَامِ. I'm not going to explain and go into details and drag on my speech. No. وَلَا ذِكْرِ. And I'm also not going to mention أَدِلَّتِهَا evidences for the things that I say. I'm just going to mention points. I'm not going to give you evidences for my arguments or my points. I won't. There's a reason why he has done, he's chosen to do that. So it's more like this book of his is more of a, as he's going to soon say, inshallah ta'ala, is like a content page. If you read a content page of a book, it doesn't give you what? It doesn't give you evidences and whatnot. It's meant to give you an overview, a guideline. So my book is like that for you. Na'am.
أقرب ما يكون لها أنها من نوع الفهرست للمسائل.
You see, that's what it is. More like a content page. And the word that the Sheikh used, which is فهرست, is more of a kashaf, as it used to be used. This now word, that term right now, has become a term which is ajami. It's a foreign word. The Arabs never used to use that word. They used to use the word kashaf. نعم
لتعرف أصولها ومقامها ومحلها من الدين.
It's better, it's correct to say لتعرف أصولها ومقامها. I know your نسخة says ومقامها, but it's correct to say ومقامها ومحلها من الدين. Hey.
ثم من له رغبة في العلم يتطلب بسطها وبراهينها من أماكنها.
The reason why I did that, the lam is lam السببية. The illa, the reason why I've done that, to just give you the bullet points and an overview and not go into details so much, is because I just want you to learn the foundations and the fundamentals. I just want you to know these principles, these fundamentals like that. And I want you to know its positions, what chapters you may put it under in terms of the religion. And he said, I also know, that anyone who has more passion, you know, sometimes people, they study a book. Once they finish that book, they say, you know what? I like what was mentioned there, but I want to go more in detail. ثُمَّ مَنْ لَهُ رَغْبَةٌ فِي الْعِلْمِ. If you have more passion and you're driven, mashallah, you're enthusiastic, and you have high aspiration, then you can go into the big books, the mutawwalat, the big books. But I'm not, my job wasn't to what? Bring that to you here. I'm just trying to give you a summary. So if you want the barahin and the evidences and the proofs and all of that, it is in its madan, in its place, you can find it now.
وَإِنْ يَسَّرَ اللَّهِ وَفَسَحَ فِي الْأَجَلِ بَسَطْتُ هَذِهِ الْمَطَالِبَ وَوَضَحْتُهَا بِأَدِلَّتِهَا.
The Sheikh said, وَإِنْ يَسَّرَ اللَّهُ, if Allah permits, and He makes it possible, وَفَسَحَ وَفَسَحَ فِي الْأَجَلِ, and Allah expands for me my lifespan. If I live on بَسَطْتُ هَذِهِ الْمَطَالِبِ, inshallah, I will expand on these units and these chapters. وَوَضَّحْتُ بِأَدِلَّتِهَا, and I will what? I will give you its evidences, each one. So the Shaykh here right now, what is he doing? تَمَنَّ الْمُصَنِّفُ, the author is hoping, أَن يُوَسِّرَ اللَّهُ لَهُ, that Allah تبارك وتعالى makes it possible for him to live for a longer time. So he can do what? So he can explain his book. He can put a sharah on it. Or he can expand on it even more. نعم. But as it said, rahimahullah rahmatan wasi'ah, he wrote this book fi akhir umrihi, in later stages of his life. That's why he's saying this. You don't say this when you're young. You don't say that, generally speaking, when you're young, if I live longer. You can only say that if you're aged. So he knew, rahimahullah, he was in a very old age. But he didn't manage to, rahimahullah, explain it or go into more extensive explanation. But this shows us something very amazing, which is, When you grow old and you've read so much, what he's put here right now is a summary and a khulasa. It is the, you know, the summary and the final conclusion of his years of experience. Alayhi rahmatullah. So for you, it might be like, oh, that's, but this for him is a what? It's a summary. Didn't the Shaykh rahimahullah previously say, ثُمَّ مَنْ لَهُ رَغْبَةٌ فِي الْعِلْمِ يَطْلُبُ بَسْطَهَا وَبَرَاهِينَهَا مِنْ أَمَاكِنِهَا, right? From the places you could go to if you have more passion and drive, in which you can find more evidences, is none other than the book Ma'arij al-Qabool. And that book is the sharah of the Sulam al-Usul ila ilm al-Usul, written by al-Imam al-Allama Hafidh al-Hakami rahimahullah. That book of Hafidh al-Hakami, the Ma'arij al-Qabool, فَإِنَّ هَذَا الْكِتَابَ لَا نَظِيرَ لَهُ. There's no book like it in terms of Tawheed al-Uluhiyah. And how he brings all the evidences that you need. Subhanallah, قال الله تعالى, قال رسول الله, evidences from the Qur'an and the Sunnah. That book, if you memorize the nazm, the poetry for it, and you also memorize the evidences for each one, mashallah, that book is something else. So that's the kind of book, if you have passion and you're driven, you have high aspiration, that's the kind of book you can go to, inshallah ta'ala, to find more evidences for these points. Now, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to go into the first asal. We're going to go into the first asal, inshallah. The first asal is at-tawheed, na'am.
أصل الأول التوحيد حد التوحيد الجامع لأنواعه هو اعتقاد العبد وإيمانه بتفرد الله بصفات الكمال وإفراده بأنواع العبادة فدخل في هذا.
So the Sheikh رحمه الله رحمة واسعة, he started his book, and as I said to you before, this book is how many أصول did he write it in? The book is consist of خمسة أصول, five أصل, five foundations. And the first of those foundations in which he starts with is what? The greatest of all foundations. أصلٌ عظيم. From the greatest أصول, and that is التوحيد. So he built his whole book and he started it off with this. And the reason for this is, my brothers and sisters who are going to watch, is this is why Allah sent all messengers. وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ وَمَا أَرْسَلَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا. Every prophet, this was the message he was sent with. عِبَادَةُ اللَّهِ وَحْدَهُ, Allah being worshipped alone. So then it's important for the Shaykh to start with that. There's no foundation greater than it. Now we want to find out what's the definition of Tawheed. Sahih? Somebody can ask you right now, what's the definition of a Tawheed? What are you going to say? Huh? And for you to come with something, you would first have to know what it is for you to come with it, right? لَأَنَّ الْحُكْمُ عَلَى شَيْءٌ فَرْءٌ عَنْ تَصَوُّرِهِ. To be able to implement something, you first of all have to understand it. So the Shaykh rahimahullah, he defines حَقِيقَةُ التَّوْحِيد, the reality and the true meaning of a Tawheed. صح? Brothers, Tawheed, if we look at the Qur'an and the Sunnah, if we look at the Qur'an of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we look at the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Tawheed is referred to two things. يُطلَقُ عَلَى مَعْنَيَيْنِ شَرْعًا. Two meanings is what Tawheed is referred to. The first one is a general meaning, مَعْنًا عَام. Tawheed is referred to there's a general meaning that it has. And the general one is what? The general one is إِفْرَادُ اللَّهِ بِحَقِّهِ, is to single Allah in His rights. You single Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in what? Allah's rights, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's general, right? The second usage in the kitab and the sunnah is what? It's a ma'nan khas, a specific, narrowed down usage. And that is إِفْرَادُ اللَّهِ بِالْعِبَادَةِ. To single Allah in what? In what? Ibadah. Before it was what? To single Allah with what? His rights. The second one is what? singling Allah specifically in what? Ibadah. So we said two meanings. Ma'nan am, a general meaning, and the second was what? Ma'nan khas, a specific meaning. And the specific meaning we said it was what? Ifradullahi bil ibadah, is to single Allah in what? Ibadah. And the general meaning was what? Ifradullahi bi haqqihi, is to single Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in his rights. When you say ifradullahi bi haqqihi, what falls under there? Al-rububiyyah, al-uluhiyyah, and al-asma' wa-sifat. Because those are all Allah's rights, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sahih? To single Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in his rububiyyah, to single Allah in his uluhiyyah, and to single Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in his al-asma' wa-sifat, his names, and that one falls under the what? The general meaning. That falls under the general meaning. As for ifradullahi tabarak wa ta'ala, singling Allah tabarak wa ta'ala bil-ibadah, is specific to which one? Uluhiyyah. And this is zubdatul risalatin ilahiyyah. Zubdatul risalatul ilahiyyah. The real gist, the true concept of Allah's message is what? The second meaning, which is ma'na al-khas. And that's why sometimes you hear the ulama when they define tawheed, what do they say? It's tawheedullah bil-ibadah. Why are they saying tawheedullah bil-ibadah when tawheedullah bil-ibadah is what? It's tawheedul uluhiyyah, and tawheedul uluhiyyah is just one of the three. Because the fighting and the arguments and the debates and the Jannah and the Nar and the Samawat and the Earth and everything was made just for this one. The reason why jihad was made permissible is because of Tawheed al-Ibadah. Why the believers were fighting the disbelievers. Because of Tawheed al-Ibadah, Allah made Jannah and Nar. Because of Tawheed al-Ibadah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala made Sama' and the heavens and the earth. All of it is because of Tawheed al-Ibadah. That's why Tawheed al-Ibadah was the discussion of the prophets with their qawm. Never did they discuss with their qawm Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. The reason is because that was Tahsil al-Hasil. Tahsil al-Hasil. It was already believed in. Everyone accepted that. Because لا يأباه, no one refuses Tawheed al-Rububiyyah except he's a what? He's a jahid. Stubborn, hard-headed. Even him, probably when he goes home, he cries to God. صحيح. لذلك فرعون who said أنا ربكم الأعلى, I am your supreme lord. What was he saying? Allah says وجحدوا بها واستيقنتها أنفسهم ظلما وعلوا. Allah said his nafs knew it. Stubborn and hard-headed he was, but he knew it. نبي الله موسى when he came to him, what did he say? لقد علمت ما أنزل هؤلاء إلا رب السماوات. You know فرعون. So that's why I believe, and والله أعلى وأعلم. Allah knows best. But I believe atheist and agnostic shouldn't be debated. Because you being here is enough for me to say there's a God. خلاص. وليس يصح في الأذهان شيء إذا احتاج النهار إلى دليل. It's not befitting for the mind if we argue about a sun that's out there, if we keep arguing about it. Is the sun there? No, it's day, it's night. It's not befitting for the mind. Your existence and you being here and you taking that cup of water and drinking it is an evidence for me God exists. خلاص قضي الأمر الذي فيه تستيان. That's the tawheed which is general, which is إفراد الله بحقه. Single Allah in his rights. حق الله تبارك وتعالى is حق الربوبية, حق الأسماء والصفات, and حق الألوهية, right? Now, the Shaykh رحمه الله is going to explain each one of those. Each one we're going to go into. الربوبية, ألوهية, الأسماء والصفات. What it means. نعم.
توحيد الربوبية الذي هو اعتقاد انفراد الرب بالخلق والرزق والأنواع التدبير.
So the Shaykh Rahimahullah, he now defines the first حق of the حقوق of Allah تبارك وتعالى. This is the general meaning. What is it? هو اعتقاد انفراد الرب. It is to believe Allah is alone. سبحانه وتعالى بالخلق creating والرزق, that's the correct way of saying it, والرزق provision, Allah provides, وأنواع التدبير, and the different types of controlling, سبحانه وتعالى. This point that the Shaykh rahimahullah is mentioning, it can be summarized in 2 points. That's it. Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, in summary, khulasa, is ifradullah, it's the single Allah. Here, in what? Ifradullahi, singling Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, bidatihi wa af'alihi. It's to single Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in his essence, and it's also to single him subhanahu wa ta'ala in his actions. You know there's no God except Allah. You also single Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in his what? His actions. So why do the scholars specifically mention al-khalq wal-razq wal-tadbir? The reason why the scholars, they choose to mention those three is that's the summary, that's the khulasa of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's actions. Allah created you. Then once you are created and you come to this earth, what do you need? You need to eat, right? And then once you come into this world and you eat, what do you need? You need somebody to run your affairs for you. Sahih? So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's actions, they say these are the khulasa of it. Meaning it falls under these three. You single Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in it. That's what? That's tawheed al-rububiyyah. Naam, hayya.
وتوحيد الأسماء والصفات وهو إثبات ما أثبته لنفسه وأثبته له رسوله من الأسماء الحسنى والصفات الكاملة العليا.
The Shaykh now goes on to the definition of what? توحيد الأسماء والصفات. Why did the Shaykh mention توحيد الربوبية and توحيد الأسماء والصفات كذا? Because توحيد الربوبية and توحيد الأسماء والصفات are إخباري. I'm a علمي. It's just knowledge based. It doesn't require action from you. Just know, believe this and know this. You know Allah created you, you know Allah provided you, you know Allah sustained for you. توحيد الألوهية on the other hand, no, you're coming. You have to come with something. It has to manifest. So these two are one side. These two are on one side. Whereas توحيد الربوبية الألوهية is a طلب والقصد. Something is requested from you. Something is intended from you. That's why the scholars sometimes divide it into two. Instead of three, they divide it into two. They put توحيد الربوبية and توحيد الأسماء والصفات in one place. And they put توحيد الألوهية by itself. توحيد الأسماء والصفات means, brothers, pay attention, this is very powerful. توحيد الأسماء والصفات means singling Allah in names and what? Ahl al-Sunnah believe what? Allah has names, right? Allah's names, they have characteristics in it. Allah's names are not just mere names. They're just not a name that has no meaning in it. No. Allah's names have a meaning in it. The qa'ida is what? أعلام بإعتبار دلالتها على الذات وأوصاف بإعتبار دلالتها على المعاني. So Allah's names are A'lam Mawsaf, in summary. Allah's names are what? A'lam wa Awsaf. So we believe the names, and we believe the what? The characteristics. And both of them are tawqifiyah. In other words, you need to get the ayah from the Quran, or a hadith from the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. If you want to affirm a name, you have to have evidence for it. Are you with me, brothers? What does it mean to single Allah in His names and attributes? It means three things. If you come with these three things, you have singled Allah in His names and attributes. Pay attention. Singling Allah in His names and attributes means these three things. One, affirming for Allah, إِثْبَاتُ مَا أَثْبَتَهُ لِنَفْسِهِ, affirming for Allah that which He affirmed for Himself. أَوْ أَثْبَتَهُ لَهُ رَسُولُهُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ, or that which His Messenger, صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ, affirmed for Him. So the first thing is, that you have to come with if you want to single Allah in His names and attributes is to affirm for Him that which He affirmed for Himself, and that which His Prophet Muhammad صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ affirmed for Him. The second thing is, تنزيه الله, is to exalt Allah. عَمَّا لَا يَلِيقُ بِهِ مِنَ النَّقَائِصِ وَالْعُيُوبِ is to exalt Allah from things that are not befitting for Him. Any deficiencies, any shortcomings, we say, nope, Allah does not have that. Allah does not sleep. Allah does not get tired. Allah does not oppress. No. Because those are what? Naqs and aib. They're deficiencies, they're faults, and Allah doesn't have that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The third and the last one, which is قَطْعُ الطَّمَعُ, get rid of the desire. And إِدْرَاكِ كَيْفِيَةِ الصِّفَاتِ, in wanting to know the how of these characteristics. You wanting to know how Allah's characteristics are. How do they... When Allah says in the Quran, يَا إِبْلِيسُ مَا مَنَعَكَ أَن تَسْجُدَ لِمَا خَلَقْتُ بِيَدَيْهِ, Iblis, what's preventing you to prostrate for the one that I have created with my two hands? Maybe like Adam. What's preventing you to prostrate for it? Get rid of the desire of wanting to know how Allah's hand looks like. Because you can't. The only way you can know the how of Allah's characteristics is one of three. And all three of them we don't have. The first one is somebody who saw Allah must tell us of how Allah looks, right? Do we have that? No. There's no one who's seen Allah. So there's no one able to tell us of how He looks, right? Are you with me? The second is what? There is nothing like Him for us to take a comparison from Him. There's not a thing that we can look at and say, oh, this is how Allah looks like. Are you with me? And the third one is that He hasn't even told us. Allah hasn't told us. So because that those three are blocked from us, we just get rid of the one thing to know how Allah's characteristics look like. Once you've come with those three, you have now come with what is known as ifradullahi bi tawhidi, ifradullahi bi asma'i wa sifati. You have now come with singling Allah in His names and attributes. Na'am.
من غير تشبيه ولا تمثيل ومن غير تحريف ولا تعطيل.
So when we affirm Allah's name subhanahu wa ta'ala, how do we affirm it? The way we affirm Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's characteristics is what? من غير تشبيه. We are not going to resemble Allah with His creation. تشبيه or تمثيل. We're not going to say Allah's hand, oh yeah, it's like my hand. Or it looks like that. We're not going to say that. Nor are we going to compare it to something. So tashbih means, you say Allah's hand looks like this. That's tashbih. Tamthil means you compare it to something. We won't do either of that. وَمِنْ غَيْرِ تَحْرِيفٍ وَلَا تَعْطِيلٍ. And we're not going to distort it and say, or negate it. We're not going to say, do that. So what do we do? إِثْبَاتٌ مِنْ غَيْرِ. What was our qa'ida? Ithbatun bila? Ha. So we do ithbatun bila tamthil. Sah? Wala tashbih. Wa tanzih, we negate from him bila ta'atil wala tahrif. That's the qa'ida. We affirm for Allah every characteristic without resembling it or comparing it to any character, other characteristics. We also negate from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala without what? Without distorting the meaning nor negating it. No. That's very important. Na'am.
وتوحيد الألوهية والعبادة وهو إفراده وحده بأجناس العبادة وأنواعها وإفرادها من غير إشراك به في شيء منها.
The Sheikh now is going into توحيد الألوهية. And it's also known as what? Ibadah. It just depends on where you look at it from. If you look at the one who is being done for, it's what? Uluhiyah. If you look at the action that's been done, it's a ibadah. You single Allah, huwa ifraduhu, it is to single Allah wahdahu alone bi ajnas al ibadah. The different types of ibadah there are. Wa anwa'iha wa afradiha. Each and every one of them. You single Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. But how do you do it? You do it with what? بِكَمَالِ الْحُبِّ with complete love. When you're doing it, it's based on with what? You're doing out of? You're doing it out of love. And you're also doing it out of ta'zim, which love brings ta'zim, right? You're honoring and you're glorifying him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second thing that you're doing out of, with it is what? وَكَمَالُ الْخُضُوعِ. And you're doing it with complete humiliation for yourself. Pay attention to this. No one can it combine for them. There's not a person who you can combine these two for. What is it? Complete love and complete humiliation. Once you do complete love and complete humiliation for somebody, it becomes a what? It becomes shirk. The reason why it becomes shirk is because there's a person who's bullying you, مثلا. Are you with me? There's a person bullying you to do something. And you will get angry. You know you can't beat this person, مثلا. You know you can't. They're stronger than you. They're more tougher than you. They're backed up. So you do for them what they've asked from you. Are you doing it with complete humiliation? Are you doing it with humiliation present? Yes, you're doing it with humiliation. Humiliation. But does that mean you love them while you're doing it? It doesn't. But you, when you're crying and you're putting your face in the dust and you're doing ruku' and you're humbling yourself in the dark and you're crying, you're begging him, you're not doing it with just humiliation. You're rather doing it with complete humiliation. No, you're nothing. And you're also doing it with what? Complete love. Complete what? Complete love. So, وَلِذَلِكَ الشيخ عبد الله الشيخ sorry الشيخ صالح بن عبد الله العصيمي he says وعبادة الرحمن غاية حبه وخضوع قاصده هما قطبان. Two things. كمال المحبة with كمال الخضوع. You know, sometimes we used to say كمال الذل, right? That word أجنبي. It's a foreign word. You don't find it in the Quran or the Sunnah being used like that. So it's better to use the words that are present in the Quran or the Sunnah. So what's the khulasa that we took from this now? When we say haqqullahi, what does it mean, the general meaning? When we say haqqullahi, what does it mean? So it's uluhiyya, rububiyya, al-asma' wa sifat. Those are the three when we say singling Allah in his haqq. And what was the specific meaning? Ifradullahi bil ibadah. Ifradullahi bil ibadah. Na'am.
Ma'atiqadi kamali uluhiyyatihi. Fadakhala fi tawhid rububiyyati ithbatul qada'i wal qadar. Wa annahu ma sha'a Allahu kana wa ma lam yasha' lam yakun wa annahu ala kulli shay'in qadir wa annahu al-ghaniyyul hamid.
This statement that the Shaykh rahimahullah, he says, is very powerful, which is that these three types from the Tawheed, Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah, and Tawheed al-Asma'i wa-Sifat. These three Tawheeds, it revolves around and it brings you back to a concept which is known as al-qada'i wal-qadar, right? Al-qada'i wal-qadar. لذلك, this statement of his, Abd al-Rahman Nasir al-Sirdi, is actually taken from Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. And Imam Ahmad said, al-qadaru qudratullah. The qadar is what? The ability of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's a statement also taken by Abu al-Wafa ibn Aqil and Abu Al-Abbas ibn Taymiyyah. They like the statement of Imam Ahmad rahimahullah. The reason is because Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, all three of those characteristics, all three of those rights, haqqul rububiyyah, haqqul uluhiyyah, and haqqul asma' wa sifat, what does it revolve around? That Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has what? Complete qudrah, complete ability. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And every single thing in this world that you see that's taking place, everything, whether you like it or not, it's all been done by the what? The qada and the qadar. But there's a difference between the two, right? What's the difference between the qada and the? Huh? Qadar is what is written on the Lawhul Mahfuz. That never gets changed. The qada is what's written with the angel. It changes, huh, for the angel. But as for what's written on the Lawhul Mahfuz, it doesn't change. So believing in the qada and the qadar goes back to what? It goes back to Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. It goes back to mainly what's Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. Na'am.
ودخل في توحيد الأسماء والصفات إثبات جميع معاني الأسماء الحسنى لله تعالى الواردة في الكتاب والسنة.
Now he's taking you back to what goes back to what? Tawheeduh? So what does Tawheed al-Rububiyya go back to? It goes back to one point, which is what? Al-Qadha wal-Qadr. What about Tawheed al-Asma wal-Sifat? It goes back to one point, which is what? إثبات جميع معاني الأسماء الحسنى. It goes back to one point. It's to affirm all the meanings that are in Allah's names. That's what it means. That are in the Quran and the Sunnah. That's the khulasa, Bab al-Asma wa-Sifat. It basically means every name. Allah, how many names does He have? Affirm those names. And we know the names of Allah, the meaning that are in it, they don't always come in dalalat al-mutabaq. Come from dalalat al-tadammun and dalalat al-iltizam, right? Because what does Allah say in the Quran? Subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahu alladhi khalaqa sab'a samawati wa min al-ardi mithlahunna yatanazzalu al-amru baynahunna li ta'lamu anna Allah ala kulli shay'in qadirun wa anna Allah qad ahata bi kulli shay'in ilma. Can Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, is Allah a creator? Does He create, subhanahu wa ta'ala? Can you create something if you don't have knowledge of it? Can you create something if you don't have the will for it? Or the ability? So automatically you've affirmed the characteristic for Allah. Just of one. The minute you said Allah is a creator, by default you have to accept that Allah is not knowledge. Because let's just hypothetically take this highlight as an example. This highlight is here. For me to make this highlighter, what do I need? I have to know how to make it, right? So I have to know how to make it. Good. What about if I have the knowledge to do it, but I don't have the ability? I don't have the substance, I don't have the stuff to do it with, I'm not in the right place for it. Can I do it? Do you see my point? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's characteristics, when you're affirming them, some characteristics will take you to the other characteristics by it. You have to accept it. And Allah mentions that in the last ayah of Surah Al-Talaq. Allah الذي خلق سبع سماوات. Allah is the one who created the seven heavens. You see? ومن الأرض مثلهن. And also the earth. The seven earths. Allah created it. يتنزل الأمر بينهن. His command is coming down. Why did Allah لتعلموا أن الله على كل شيء قدير. To show you that I can do everything. قدرة. وأن الله قد أحاط بكل شيء علما. And also that Allah encompass everything with knowledge. So the خلق gives yourself that قدره and علم. So this is called, what is it called? دلالة المطابق, دلالة التضمن, and دلالة الالتزام. نعم. So you have to affirm it like that. We'll stop there, inshallah ta'ala, for today. Anything which I have said that was wrong, فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي وَمِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ وَاللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ بَرِئَانِ مِنْ سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ